Hi guys, we're at the just at a local place here in Raleigh to check out different frame rates with the Mavic Air. As you know, the Mavic Air can shoot in different frame rates. It can shoot in, you know, 4K 30, 4K 24, and also, you know, 60 frames per second and up to 120 frames per second. So I wanted to test that out a little bit and see which one actually looks the best for slow motion type videos. One thing I've noticed with the Mavic Air is I've done this several times is to forget to put down these little legs here. It'll fly with them up, but what it won't do is it won't allow the gimbal to set up correctly because it'll be flat on the ground. And when it's going through its little initialization, if it's flat like that, it'll be flat on the ground and it'll overheat the gimbal. So make sure you don't forget to put these down. All right, so let's get started. Okay, first off, I want to just do normal mode. So this is 4K at 24 frames per second. Do 10 seconds of that. Next, I'm gonna do 120 is the best I can get from a light category. Ideally, you want to be twice the speed, so I'd want to be at 240, but in this case, I don't want to mess with the ISO and take away the picture quality. So we'll go 10 seconds like that. All right, now let's do something a little bit different. And I'm gonna go back to 4K, 24 frames per second. Go into tripod mode. Do a little pan. Okay. Nothing miraculous here. Just testing out. Alright, so now I'm going to go to 2.7K at 60 frames per second. Okay. I'm going to go back the other way. Try to make it as smooth as possible. All right, let's go back in. 2.7, now I'm gonna go to 1080p at 120 frames per second. All right, this is 120 frames per second. Pretty cool. 120 frames per second rising. Okay, we are in 1080p, 120 frames per second. Just gonna go forward a bit. Maybe get a quick little rise. All right, let's see what we can do. 1080p, 120 frames per second. Tap fly. All
check it, put the place up.
The 60 frames per second and the 120 frames per second is really good for shooting slow motion with your quad. So this will be really good if you want to, you know, start capturing some kind of B-roll for your videos that you put online. Just a way to mix it up, you know, it's always something different to see when you got the, you know, the actual normal pace. And you can only slow things down so much without it falling apart if you do it in post. So you can always drag out the clip and slow it down and things like that, but it starts to fall apart. So with these guys, with the Mavic Air, you know, it's recording at 100 megabits per second, and it can record at 120 frames per second in 1080p, which is really all you need for something like YouTube. I mean, you have 4K cameras, and you basically compress it down, and you can still play it in 1080p on YouTube, and it looks amazing. And so there's really no worries about degradation of quality. Not that the naked eye can see. I mean, it's definitely degradation of quality, but you're not going to do a 20-minute epic slow motion video on YouTube. It's going to be quick little clips, 3 seconds here, 3 seconds there at the most. So it's just good ways to do that. The other good thing about shooting in slow motion is it takes away all the camera shakes, which you shouldn't really have any with, you know, with a smooth gimbal, but if you're moving the controllers back and forth, and it should smooth that out, so it takes away some of the shake. So try that out, and let me know in the comments how it goes for you. And post your videos in the comments as well. I'd like to check them out, just to see what other folks are doing. But for me, that's about it. The rain is starting to come in, the camera's a little bit wet, and I gotta get back. So if you like this video, hit subscribe down below. Drop me a comment if you have any questions, or if you wanna show me the videos that you shot in slow motion. Love to see them. So with that, I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.